doing? Hi, you little dork face. Pandora. Pandora. Hi. What you doing, dork face? What you doing? You're too much. Oh my God, I can't with you. Fans. Okie dokie. I'm being glared at. Let's see if I can get the camera out without. Ah, man, I unadjusted the tripod. I'm being glared at. Let me do this and then I take you out, okay? So, okay. Pretty much out of his tank whenever he's awake. But I'm gonna do some painting first and then I'll take him out. Because I don't want him running around while I'm doing this. Okay, here we go, we got a big head. Okay, what mottling does she need? She already had that. Definitely doesn't need hair yet. I think I did purple on her already. Come here! Nope. Definitely did that one. Yell at your paint jars and then they'll cooperate. That's how it works. Don't argue with me, it works. It doesn't work. Alright, and we need a sponge. A yellow sponge. Yeah, I cleaned all my brushes the other day. Now I've got all fresh brushes. I always whine about when all my brushes get all dirty. In many a video at the end, I'm whining about that. Because I'm like, oh, now I have to clean my paintbrushes because they're all dirty. I probably clean my paintbrushes a lot more than most artists do. Like, I feel like a lot of artists, they have, like, brushes dedicated to certain colors, whereas I just kind of, like, use the brushes for every color and just clean them. There are some brushes that I have that are, like, for definite darker colors. If you use a color so dark on a brush, eventually there is no going back. Oh yeah, that's nice. I like this. Nice. It's really hard to, like, get down into, like, under her chin here, because it's so, like, she basically has no neck. And then her head ring, neck ring, is it sticks out further than the bottom of her neck, so it's really hard to get down in there with a sponge. With a sponge. And I'm mad because I was gonna be, all adult and responsible for once, and I went on the Shoppers Drug Mart website, and filled out the form to get my flu shot because I was gonna suck it up and be an adult and be responsible for once, and then they didn't have any. I guess I'm not that upset about it because I didn't have to get poked. But this time, it's not because I'm being a coward. This time I actually have an excuse not to, because there are none. That yellow. That yellow did good things. It's doing good things. It's a good yellow. Good yellow. Who's a good yellow? So I start a new job tomorrow. Like an actual, I was actually hired by a place. I mean, I like to like consider this as kind of a job because I can make money with it and I like to dedicate myself to it, but there's a reason I'm broke. I'm not selling enough dolls. Which, by the way, I have, if you're looking for a newborn sized baby boy, or even a girl, I could change it to a girl if you really wanted to. I have a real-born Clyde awake that's, sitting there waiting to be taken home by somebody. People keep saying that they'll buy him, and then at the last minute they just like disappear or like change their mind. Like right up, like it's all agreed on and everything, and then it comes down to, okay, now all that's left is payment, and then I'll ship it off, and then they just sort of like disappear. And now little baby Clyde is very sad because nobody wants him. He's over there in the bassinet going, why doesn't anybody want me? You don't hear it I'm so like conflicted. Because this is Canada. Hello from Canada. And it's November, beginning of November, and it's supposed to be getting cold, but we've had like summer weather for the past few days, and now like I like it. It's a good thing. But at the same time, it's depressing because I know that any day now it's going to go away and we're going to be thrown into Arctic hell. Leave it to me to find a job at last when, just when we're about to go into, full on blizzard season. walking that, folks. Not too sure what to, really expect or think of the whole new job thingy. It's like a cashier position. And I wasn't like, that wasn't one of the things I was really setting out looking for. But I mean, beggars can't be choosers, right? I mean, I'm gonna do my best at it. I'm just not sure if I, like, I'm not sure that that's, like, I'm a good fit for that position. But yet again, I have, like, virtually no skills that most, basic entry-level jobs require, so it's, like, I'm gonna go in there and I'm gonna do my best and we'll see what happens. She really needed that yellow layer. Nice. Get her back up on the hooky thingies. There. Nice to meet you, sir. Stuff. I swear nothing collects dust more easily than vinyl. Okay, silicone maybe. Okie dokie. Open fingers. I guess it's open hand, not open fingers. If your finger's open, you might have a problem. Might want to see a doctor about that one. It's just me, but I feel like she has really long arms. bigger kit, but I feel like. Well. No, her arms aren't longer than the toddler's arms. I guess the Tatiana toddler kit just has chubbier arms than she does. Maybe that's it. It makes them look longer. Because the Tatiana is same length and same limbs as the Ariana. And they are 28-inch kits, and this is a 26-inch. So she's either going to... I think that this doll is probably going to wear, like, 6 to 9 months, maybe straight 9 months, we'll see. I know that the 7 month June Awake kit that I made for myself, all of her wardrobe is 6 to 9 months and a couple of straight 9 months. And she's a 25 inch, and 1 inch can make a big difference in dolls, so we'll see if 26 inch kits are going to take something bigger or not. I'm thinking she's like, she's probably a size 3 shoe. Her feet are huge. If she were a real baby, she'd probably take a size 2, but with dolls, you have to be careful with the shoe size. Usually you gotta get bigger shoes than you think you would. The Tatiana toddler that I had in my personal collection, she wore a size 2 shoe. And her feet are definitely smaller than this one. Like, it doesn't look weird or anything, but... I mean, dolls, most of the kits, not most, like, there's a lot of kits that have, like, very large hands, very large feet, or very small hands and very small feet. Like, I don't think a baby that would be, like, the age that this size of kit would be, I don't think... that age of real baby would ever wear a size 3 shoe, and I'm like 98% sure that this doll is going to wear size 3 shoes. But like, as long as you paint them the right way, usually unrealistically large or small feet and hands don't tend to look weird on the dolls. It's only when they have, like, really big heads that looks weird. There's a couple of kits, and I won't name names, that have, like, very, very large heads. Or, like, very, very large foreheads. And it's like, oh my god! Your baby's got a balloon head! Like, the kits aren't ugly or anything, they're cute kits, but it's just, like, that kit looks like it should have, like, toddler limbs, and it has these little 19-inch baby limbs, and it's like, something's not right. Thank you. Okay, we've got la oven outside. Cooking a pair of legs. We're gonna close that. Yeah, there's really no point in putting it outside if you're just gonna leave the door open because the fumes are just gonna come in. Alright. Figured I'd do, you know, get all the baking done tonight because tomorrow it's probably gonna be cold. Anyways, that's all for now, frog fans. Thank you so much. Keep living the froglings life, and we shall see you tomorrow. Bye.